story in ESPN the magazine is tearing the lid off what goes on behind the scenes at the Olympic Village. The drinking, the all-night partying, the scandal. It's a look at what really happens when thousands of the world's best athletes get together. And our weekend anchor, Dan Harris, you're going to give us some of these details?
I am. Tough all assignment.
Right. I'm sure.
Thank you, Robin. Mm-hmm. These accounts make the Olympic Village sound more like Peyton Place or ancient Rome during one of its more rambunctious periods. Some athletes have even reportedly appropriated the motto of Las Vegas, "What happens in the village stays in the village."
The beautiful and buff gold medalist Hope Solo says there were a few key moments at the 2008 Olympics that were not solo at all, telling ESPN the magazine that she sneaked an unnamed celebrity back to her room in the Olympic Village, a major violation of the rules. She calls it her Olympic secret.
You mix great bodies with considerable confidence and in some cases substantial wealth, and you have a recipe for very effective game.
And that's not all. After the U.S. women's soccer team won the gold that year, Solo says she and her teammates went on an all-night bender with actor Vince Vaughn. Quote, "When we were done partying, we got out of our nice dresses, got back into our stadium coats, at which point," she says, "they went on live television drunk."
There was no pressure going into the game other than it being a World Cup, an Olympic final.
You're taking those athletes out of their natural habitat and you're dropping them into the world's largest co-ed dorm.
Solo is just one of many athletes now spilling stories to ESPN about the Olympic Village, a place where reportedly officials regularly stock 100,000 condoms.
In many cases, it's celebratory sex for the winners. In the case of the losers, it's a consolation prize.
American javelin thrower Bro Greer tells ESPN he had sex with three women a day during the 2000 Olympics. Skier Carrie Scheinberg says in 1994, some German bobsledders offered her their gold medals in exchange for sex. Swimmer Ryan Lochte estimates 70 to 75% of all Olympians are having sex. As he puts it poetically, hey, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. John Godina, silver and bronze medalist in shot put, tells ABC News, athletes go there focused, and once their job is done, they have fun. They don't necessarily go there looking for it, but things happen. You learn not to ask a lot of questions.
And apparently, the party even continues on the plane ride home. American target shooter Josh Lacatus tells ESPN that the Olympians took over the back of one of the planes. Quote, "Everybody partnered up fairly rapidly, and when they'd bring the drink cart through, we would send it back dry."
Ooh.
Yes.
All righty there. Well, thanks, Dan.
My pleasure.